Hello family, and welcome to Kamy Ideas. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the post notification bell so you receive notifications whenever I upload a new video. I'm very tired and having a headache, but I must record this video today anyway. So in today's video, I just want us to talk about the nursing school fees, or let me say the financial aspect of nursing school. Maybe you do hear people say nursing school is expensive. You don't even have a clue about what is entailed in nursing school fees. Is it just about pay your fees and you are going, or what is inclusive in the nursing schooling? So today we'll be discussing what is entailed, the fees and other expenses and other stuff. So first of all, I want to refer to this adage that goes like, if you think education is expensive, then try ignorance. And I buy into it because education in itself is expensive, but ignorance is much more expensive. All right, so you can bear with me that education is expensive right from preschool to university and beyond. Education is very expensive these days, so it's not just about the nursing. And you bear with me that preschoolers these days are paying much more than those in the tertiary. Let's talk about nursing school fees. What is adding up to make the school fees bulky? First year or admission fee is always expensive. It's a bit higher than subsequent fees that will come. So when you're reporting for the first time, and it depends on every school and their policies. Okay, there are some schools that include uniforms, aprons, mattresses, customized crafts, school cloth, anniversary, whatsoever, into the school fees. And there are some schools also that add just only the nursing uniform, and then maybe if they have a school cloth, they add it or something. So if you are comparing a school that is giving students adding mattress, customized crafts, school cloth, uniforms to your school fees, and a school that is only adding uniform alone, the fees is not going to be the same. So nursing school, it depends on the college you find yourself, but then there is always a stated amount of money for Ministry of Health for every first year student, or for admission fees, okay? And that includes your feeding, your hostel facility, and whatsoever social, whatever the school has. So wherever you find yourself depends on the fees you pay. So maybe I'm in Borga NTC, I'm paying 4,000 cedis for a year, and you are in Chufuprasso and you are paying 5,000 cedis. So I would say you have to look into things. Look at what Chufuprasso is giving their student and compared to Borga NTC. Maybe Prasso we are giving this that, and Borga 2 is giving this that. So that's what brings about the variations in the school fees. So nursing school fees depends on the college you find yourself. But then we move. There are schools that take fees for a whole year. They pay for a year, and other schools too pay per semester. And if you're in a school that pay per year, it's not by force that you must pay the fees everything at once. If you don't have, you can be paying it in bits until you are done paying. But then they only disturb you if you don't finish paying by the end of second semester, when you are finishing to go to the next level. You'll be in the examination and they will come and be sacking you. They are owing fees. Yes, and they will sack you too. So, and if you are in a school that pay per semester, you know, maybe in the semester you are paying 2,000 cedis per semester or 2,500 cedis per semester. You gather your money, pay in bits, maybe pay reporting, and after midterm you go and settle the rest. Okay, I pray that you find a linear school with a good principal who will not come with big canes and be lashing your back because you are owing fees. That was just my day. So that's it. And so I can't state the amount, that this is the amount of money nursing school you pay. Maybe a school can be paying 5,000, another school can be paying 4,500 for admission fees or something. So I can't compare that to another school. So every school and their policy. So that's nursing school for you. What are some of the other things that add up to make the school look like nursing school is expensive? Let's talk about practicals. Okay, when we talk about practicals, every school probably has a school lab. Okay, we have a skills lab where you go to practice after lectures. We have days for practicals. You all move to the skills lab laboratory with your instructor and carry out procedures. But then whatever you learn in the school's practical, most of the items you find in the school practicals, you will see them in the hospitals when you are doing your clinicals. And they only bring out some of the things during licensing examination times for practicals. So when you are doing your clinicals, you will find things for care for hand and feet, mouth care items, bed making and those things. You won't find them in the ward. Okay. So if you are in nursing school and maybe you've learned about how to care for hands and feet, okay, or mouth care, and you go to the ward and you find yourself with an old, this old lady, you know very well that this lady needs mouth care or hands care for hands and feet. The old lady or old man is having overgrown nails and you want to just help them trim it. You can get your pedicure set, okay? We sell some like 3-2 cities or so. Get your set of pedicure items or manicure items and just use it for your own practicals. It's for your own good. And the more you try your hands on these things, the more you become good, because nursing is full of practicals. You learn theory and you put it into practice. If you don't practice, you will not be competent. But then if you just care for hands and feet and it's just theory, the first day, maybe if you're not fortunate and on examination, they give you such a procedure, you'll be there and be fumbling. You hold the patient leg and hands and you are shivering because the examiner will be standing on you like this, watching you carry out the procedure. And they'll ask, are you done? They are rating you and asking you questions. Are you done? This, that. So the more you try your hands on practicals while you're on clinical, the more competent and confident you become. So if you are in school, you would want to have personal items for yourself, maybe BP apparatus, you want to have your stethoscope, you want to have other equipment, you can use your thermometers and things, other stuff. For your own practical, so when you are going on your clinicals, you carry your personal items with you. Maybe you find yourself in a facility that they have, maybe your ward, you have just one sphere for checking of BP, and you have your personal thing. You can bring it and be using it for your own stuff, okay? So it all adds up to make the school fees look like, because you spend a lot in nursing school, okay? Aside the school fees, practical items, and just for learning sake or learning materials, you also add up to the fees. And let's talk about clinicals too. When you are going for clinicals, you know, we have internal and then external clinicals for every semester. So you go to school, you learn for some time, go for clinicals. And when you're on your clinicals, you rent on your own. Like my school, you rent on your own. You go and look for your own accommodation, feed yourself till you come back. So if the school is giving you like 6 weeks to do clinicals, you're supposed to take care of yourself, eat morning, afternoon, evening, look for your own accommodation, whatever you do and survive and come back to school. It's your own cup of tea. The school has a bus, or the school bus will just convey you guys to your various destinations. Maybe this number of people are going to this hospital, this number of people are going to this hospital. They could just do that for her. They could just carry us to your place of clinicals, your hospital, and then return. So you can look for your own accommodation, feed yourself, and come back to school. And if your school is fortunate and they want to give you something, but then I doubt. But then before we reported to school, we heard there was a principal in our school who used to do that. When students are going on clinicals, they calculate some amount of money, give to every individual, because you've already paid for feeding and they covered the whole of that month, and you are on clinicals for like 4 weeks or 6 weeks. So principal will just he will calculate some amount of money, give to every student, let me say 100 cedis for your upkeep. So if you're not fortunate to get something, I never had any. So if your school is not doing any of those things, be prepared to rent your own apartment or your accommodation. So we go in 2-3s, just combine, contribute money, rent a place, and stay together to do your clinicals. And I remember my first clinicals, we were like 11 people, 11 students in a chamber and hall, 6 year, 5 day, and we're choked like we're in prison. Ah. So nursing school is like that. So expenses, clinicals, practicals, and then you talk about buying books. Every semester, every teacher will come out with their handouts. You have to get the handouts to make your learning easier, because the explanation in the handouts are much, they explain and add more practical examples than just going to pick a very fat Rose and Wilson textbook to be reading and you don't get it. So handouts are there for you to buy, okay, and buying the handouts and all that add up to make the school fees look bulk, yeah. And nursing school, I always say, is good as it's more comforting to have a support system. Maybe have someone to sponsor education, okay, and even the sponsorship, that depending on your family, if your family is that okay and they are taking care of your fees, you don't think about that. But there are other people too that, apart from that, they struggle and get their first semester fee, first year's fees. Whatever the other fees will come from is in the hands of God. But then, don't lose faith. Me, I'm a faith girl. I believe in God. I believe in faith. And I believe you. If you are destined to be a nurse, so far as you've gotten admission, you find yourself there. God will make a way. And one thing is, in terms of scholarship, there are people that school on scholarship. And I don't have much information about the scholarship thing. But then, if you find yourself in a college where paying fees is difficult, you can consult your teachers. Maybe they can link you up with an organization that can sponsor your fees. And they have their terms and conditions. Yeah, but I don't have much knowledge about how you can get scholarship to go to a nursing school in Ghana, like nursing college. So you can find out from your school tutors and they can help you out with their fees. But in all, I always say that whatever you are doing right now, as you are waiting for your admission letter or you are even planning to go to school, apply to nursing school, try and be saving money small, okay? Try and save a bit so that when you get your admission and all these miscellaneous expenses are coming up, you can take care of them, all right? And nursing school is full of pay this, pay that right from first year till you complete. Even after your national service, you have to pay this, go and register this. So, but then nothing good comes easy. So these are the processes involved to sharpen or shape you to become a better nurse, okay? So that's it with the nursing school fees. So whether it's expensive, what might be expensive to me might not be expensive to you. And what might be expensive to someone might not be expensive to me. So it depends on your pocket. And I don't want to generalize to say that nursing school fees is so high that you cannot afford. There is always a way out in every situation. This is what I'll be sharing with you today. Stay blessed. Invite people to join the channel now. Keep supporting the channel by not skipping the ads. Let the ads finish playing so that you watch the video. God bless you. Stay tuned for subsequent more interesting videos.